हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर अल्पना दुबे. आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ग्रास वाटरवे एंड डिज़ाइन. इन द कोर्स ऑफ सॉइल एंड वाटर कंजर्वेशन इंजीनियरिंग मोस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक हैव बीन कवर्ड बाई द मिंटू जॉब सर एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर ओनली डिज़ाइन ऑफ ग्रास वाटरवे. Before starting the grass waterway design, first we should know what is the watershed and what is the runoff, because if we know these terms we can easily understand what is the purpose of grass waterway and what is the purpose of designing of grass waterway. So now, what is the watershed? Watershed is a area drained by a stream in such a way that all flow originating in that area is discharged through a single outlet. In a single word, we can say watershed is an area which has a single outlet and all water is going in that outlet only. So watershed is also known as drainage basin, catchment and drainage area. All these words are synonyms of watershed, but we can differentiate it by its area. Drainage basin is in larger in area as compared to catchment and watershed, whereas watershed is smallest in area than catchment. So this figure show a typical watershed, and if we want to draw a watershed in a paper, this will be like that. So water has mainly three component: outlet, boundary and stream line. So in the figure we can see the outlet of watershed and what is the boundary. Boundary is nothing but a ridge line which separate the watershed from the another one. And streamline is a path in which water convey from the different area of the watershed to the outlet. One more thing which we should know about the watershed, that is time of concentration. Time of concentration is a time taken by the water to convey from the remotest point to the outlet. So after understanding the watershed, now we come to the grass waterway. Grass waterway are the channels established for the transport of concentrated flow at safe velocity from the catchment using adequate erosion resistance vegetation which cover the channels. These channels are used for the safe disposal of excess runoff from the cropland to some safe outlet without forming erosion. What happened in the watershed, runoff velocity is very high, so it increased the soil erosion in the form of gully and rill. So here grass water will protect the soil from the erosion by its vegetation cover, and the vegetation cover slows the water flow, minimizing channel surface erosion. It can also be used as outlet for water release from contoured and terrace system and from diverted channel also. This management practice can reduce sedimentation of nearby water bodies and pollutant in runoff. The vegetation improve the soil aeration and water quality due to its nutrient removal through plant uptake. Okay, grass waterway is nothing but a simple drainage channel which we use to drain or divert water from the catchment or watershed. Here there are some pictures, actual pictures of field that stabilize the grass waterway of different shape. Here you can see the grass waterway. So grass waterway may be man-made or natural, and it is covered with erosion resistance crop and constructed along the slope of area. After understanding the purpose of grass waterway and what concept of grass waterway, here we list the data required for designing the waterway. First, the list of information we used to for designing the grass waterway is data based on the watershed. It included watershed area, soil characteristics which consist of type of soil and texture of soil, and then crop cover, and then topography. All these data will be used for calculating the peak runoff rate, and we also use grade of waterway, it's mean what should be the grade or what should be the slope of waterway when we design it, and information on vegetation cover adopted for selecting the roughness coefficient, and erodibility of soil of grass waterway to predict the soil erosion, allowable flow velocity it will be assumed. First, for calculating the peak runoff rate, we should know what is the runoff. Runoff is described as the part of the water cycle that flows over land as surface water instead of being absorbed into groundwater. Runoff calculates in two different forms. First, peak discharge and total runoff volume. When we design a drainage structure, we have to calculate peak discharge, and it calculate in term of meter cube per second. And if we want to design a storage structure, we have to calculate the volume of total volume of that watershed, and the unit will be kept in meter cube. So here we are going to design a drainage structure. Grass waterway is a drainage structure, so we have to calculate peak discharge instead of total runoff volume. Okay, for calculating runoff, we can use rational method, that is Q peak is equal to CIA upon 360. Here Q peak is equal to peak runoff rate, that is in meter cube per second, and C is equal to runoff coefficient, I is equal to rainfall intensity for a duration equal to time of concentration, and for a recurrence interval, A is equal to simply watershed area, that is in hectare. Here you have to check out the unit of all the component, like I is in mm per hour, A is equal to in hectare, and Q peak is equal to in meter cube per second. So first, runoff coefficient is a fraction of rainfall resulting into surface runoff. It is a dimensionless number, and the values vary from 0 to 1. If your soil is very sandy, it's mean your infiltration rate is very high, and your runoff is very slow, so the value of C will be near to 0. And if, because there is a minimum or no runoff, and if your soil is like clay type and infiltration is very slow and runoff is very high, so the value will be near to 1, where infiltration is 0 and runoff is high. Generally, three shape of waterway is designed, that is trapezoidal, triangular and parabolic. So here we can show the trapezoidal shape of waterway, in which B is the bottom width of channel, small t is the top width of channel, small d is your depth of channel. Here capital T is a free board. Free board is a extra space which we have to given for safety purpose, and capital D is equal to your depth of channel from bottom to that free board. This is a triangular shape of waterway. Here also D is equal to your depth, small t is your top width, capital T is your free board, width of your free board, and D is equal to depth of channel. And this is a parabolic shape of waterway. Generally, if we construct trapezoidal or triangular shape of waterway, after some time, after 5 or after 6 years, all the shape of water will convert into parabolic shape due to deposition of sediment. Okay. After deciding the shape of waterway, we have to calculate geometric parameters of different geometric parameters, and here is the list of formula which we can use to calculate all the parameters for different shape of waterway. Here A is equal to your cross sectional area. We all know what is the cross sectional area, and P is equal to weighted perimeter. Weighted perimeter is a perimeter of a cross sectional area which is weighted by water, and R is equal to hydraulic radius. Hydraulic radius is the ratio of area divided by weighted perimeter. So we can calculate all these geometric parameters by using these formulae. So from this image we can this image is giving some idea about the grass waterway. This is a grass waterway with vegetation cover, and all the water from the surrounding is coming in this waterway, and there is a filter strip to trap the sediment. Here sediment, it is very important to remove the sediment, and the sediment should not be go directly in the grass waterway because it reduces the capacity of structure over time. After deciding the peak runoff rate and the shape and size of waterway, we will consider the velocity of flow. Velocity of flow is depend upon type and condition of vegetation and density to resist the erosion. So from the research, there are some permissive velocity have been decided by the researcher for different grass covers. If your soil is very poor in condition due to poor grass cover, the range of velocity should be in between 0.9 to 1.2 meter per second. If the grass cover is in good condition, we can keep the velocity from 1.2 to 1.8 meter per second. If the condition is excellent, then we can keep the velocity from 2 to 2.5 meter per second. So this figure show the pattern of velocity for of grass cover water. If your channel is covered by grass, the velocity of upper surface is very high and it decreases, and in the bottom the velocity is very very low due to the resistance of the grass. So this is the benefit of the covered grass. It reduces the energy of water and finally reduces the erosion. After that, we have to consider a slope of waterway. It should be generally keep in the range from below the 5%, and it should not be exceed from 10%. And then we have to cross the velocity by using the Manning's formula. Here V is equal to flow velocity, that is in meter per second. Your S is equal to slope, that is in fraction. R is equal to hydraulic mean radius, and N is equal to Manning's roughness coefficient, which is generally taken as 0.04 for grass waterway. Here your velocity is not independent parameter, it's depend on your slope, hydraulic geometric parameter, that is hydraulic radius, and N. So in the previous slide I have discussed that velocity have to be assumed. Here we cross-check the velocity because we calculated several parameter, cross-sectional area and hydraulic radius. So we have to check your all the considerable parameter is accurate or not. That we can check from this Manning's formula. If your calculated velocity is within the range of your assumed velocity, that means your design parameter is in considerable condition. If it is not, you have to again assume the parameter and calculate all the things. So this is a summary of design step of grass waterway. First, you have to determine the peak runoff rate of watershed, and after that find out the permissible flow velocity. That you have to assume according to your grass cover. If it is in good condition, you can increase your velocity, but your grass cover is very poor, so you have to keep the velocity as minimum as possible. And after assuming the velocity and calculating the peak discharge, compute the cross-sectional area of the grass waterway using the equation Q is equal to A and V. Here you have calculated the value of Q, and also you have to assume the value of V, so you can calculate the cross-sectional area. After that, compute various dimension to suit the area of cross-section obtained in step 3. After that, calculate the hydraulic radius by using given formula, and then assume the slope of the channel. It should not be more slope, because if the slope is more, it increase the soil erosion. And after that, using the value of slope, compute the flow velocity at the section taken into consideration using Manning's formula. So if your computed value is equal to or less than your assumed value of velocity, that means your design is perfect or in considerable condition. But if your calculate value exceed your assumed value, you have to again repeat the step 2, and further you have to calculate all the parameters, and then it is a trial and error method. You have to assume the data, calculate the value, and if it is not in the range, then again you have to assume the data. So after understanding the grass waterway design and calculation, we just solve a problem. The problem is design a grass waterway of parabolic shape to carry a flow of 2.6 meter cube per second down a slope of a 3%. The waterway has a good stand of grass and a velocity of 1.75 meter per second can be allowed. Assume the value of n in Manning's formula as 0.04. Here you have the value of q, so we no need to calculate the discharge, that is, so we can directly assume the velocity. We have to assume the velocity of v, but here also the velocity is given for good stand of grass conditions, so no need of again assuming the velocity. That so we have the discharge value and we have the velocity value, so that is 1.75 meter per second. Here we calculate the value of cross section, and so the value of cross section is 1.485 meter square after calculation, and here we have to assume the top width and depth. These two parameters we will assume according to our cross sectional area. After that we calculate the area, that is in limit of 1.6 meter square. So now we calculate the weighted perimeter and hydraulic radius by using the formula, and after that we calculate the velocity by using the Manning's formula, and we found the velocity is 2.26 meter per second, but our given velocity is 1.75 meter per second. That's why the velocity exceed the permissible limit, so we again have to assume the another value of cross section. So this is the second trial. Here we assume the value of t is 6 meter and the value of d is 0.4 meter. In first case, our value of t is less, that is 4 meter, and value of d, depth, is more, that is 60 centimeter. It is more easy to change the cross sectional area as compared to change the slope. So here we can try with the depth and top. So after calculating all the parameter, we found the velocity is 1.7 meter per second. The velocity is within the permissible limit, so the carrying capacity of waterway is more than the required, hence the design of water is satisfactory. A suitable freeboat to the depth is to be provided in the final dimension, that we can take a okay. Here is some maintenance of grass waterway. The outlet should be safe and open as not to delay the free flow, and grass waterway should not be used as footpath, animal track or grazing ground. It can damage the grass waterway. Frequent crossing of waterway by wheeled vehicles should not be allowed, and newly stabilized waterway should be kept under the strict watch because it takes time to stabilize and it takes time to grow the grasses. And the large waterway should be kept under protection with fencing. Waterway must be inspected frequently during first and two rainy season after the construction. If there is a break or there is any damage in the channel, that should be immediately repaired before the rainy season. And the level of grass in waterway should be kept in low and uniform as possible to avoid the turbulence of flow. If the grasses is very big, it increase the turbulence and also increase the soil erosion. Thank you.